Gee, Shrek, you're not going to believe where I'm at today. I'll tell you what, I'm in one of the coolest places that you're ever going to see in the state of Arizona. And if you get an opportunity and you're just east of Tucson, Arizona, what you're going to find is a movie set called Mescal. And if you know, if you've never been here, you are going to see things that you have seen in some of the most popular Western movies anywhere. Now, right here, if you take a look, that is two houses that you might be familiar with from the movie Tombstone. Now, that would be Wyatt's house right there. They thought that there's no way that they could let this town die. So what they did was they bought it, and with a group of volunteers, brought this historical site back to actually shooting movies today. You're going to see the mercantile store right here. You come in here, we're going to come in the back way. Now, in the movie Tombstone, that is the cigar shop, and next to that would have been the opium den right there. So that would have been the opium den here. Now, if you look in here, this is the mercantile shop right here. Now, if you look at this hotel right here, and you're in the Wayback Machine, what you're going to find is this was a prop for a movie with Frank Sinatra. So can you imagine seeing Lee Marvin? Can you even... DiCaprio, Sharon Stone, all these famous movie stars of the time that spent their time through here and shot in these locations here. Now, some of these are false fronts, but actually some of them are actually complete buildings, which is pretty incredible. We're going to take a look at the Grand Palace Hotel right here. Isn't this incredible? Because a lot of times you expect to see false fronts and things like that, but then you look in here and you see this historical type building, which is, look at this. Is that not incredible? So again, some of these are false fronts, but some of these you could actually shoot movies in as well. Now they're actively still shooting movies. So let's take a walk through history. Now Frank Sinatra shot in this, is that correct?
Yes, he did. Dirty Dingus McGee.
Dirty Dingus, oh, that is an awesome movie. Now, Lee Marvin.
Lee Marvin, Glenn Ford. And of course, everybody knows Doc Holliday. Here we are in Doc Holliday's room.
Wow. So this was in the movie Tombstone. This was his.
Yes, this was his room with Big Nose Kate.
Wow. How incredible is that? Step out here. Look at this. Wow. Is that not incredible? Now, the next location we're going to go, the Insane Asylum, was actually a place where I was told there were two movies that you might remember. I'm sure there was a dozen more than that. But it was in the movie Tombstone, and it was also in Judge Roy Bean. Now, if you remember right here in this corner, this would have been the place where Doc Holliday passed away, right in this location right here, which is pretty neat when you think about it. And then you look here, up there would have been the scaffolding where Paul Newman, right?
Yes.
Paul Newman and Judge Roy Bean. That's where he was hung, right on that location right there.
In terms of pointing out that the problems they had, like one of the biggest things with me is their gun rigs. They're wearing these Buscadero rigs, which were never anything in the real old
right.
Ones. You know, so they got the loop on the belt and they're hanging down here. And that's a fast draw thing and nothing, but it's all Hollywood
right. That. You know, he just reminded me of something I read last night about Tombstone that I didn't know. They had the first public swimming pool anywhere in Arizona. Yeah. They had a bowling alley, and the ice cream shop was where Wyatt Earp supposedly had a sweet tooth. Now, I would have never thought that there'd been that much stuff going on. And now we'll take the famous walk. down the alley where history was made. Right here. This is where we kind of got started once, and then we ended up. Now, right down this alley, if you look to the left, that's where they shot the famous gunfight at the OK Corral. So you'd have had all the heroes right there. This is the exact location that they shot this, and I'm telling you what, it's pretty incredible. It is pretty incredible to see this. Here would have been the exact location right here. Building where they shot Buffalo Soldiers out there. So right on this area right here would have been where all that happened. And you know, if it wouldn't have been for that scene, it wouldn't have been for that movie, I tell you, we'd have lost a lot of history. You know what we're going to do is we're going to take a run down to Tombstone to see the exact real location and talk a little bit about, you know, how the movie Tombstone really saved the town of Tombstone. So, you know, that's one time where movies actually, you know, helped history, because if it wouldn't have been for the movie and the popularity, then we might have lost Tombstone itself, because they were on the verge at one time of not having a lot of success.